Hello everyone, this is Tim with another review. Today's game we get to review Milanoir, a game by Italo Games, Good Shepherd Entertainment, and Gambitious. Thanks to all of them for providing a code to download and review this game. It is very much appreciated. Now, as I usually do, let's get into the trailer in the eShop.
Sei anni di prigione sono lunghi. Che hai intenzione di fare adesso? Voglio trovare quel bastardo che mi ha mandato dentro. Questo tradimento è una cosa che si porterà dietro fino alla fine dei suoi giorni. E non sono molti. Se c'è una cosa che ho imparato dalla vita, è che non esistono amici, soltanto complici.
After watching that trailer, I gather you guessed this game is for mature audiences. With that, I would say you guessed right. This game is rated M for mature in the US for its blood, nudity, sexual content, strong language, and violence. And man, they weren't kidding. This game was definitely meant for mature audiences only, so please keep that in mind when watching this review. I did try to cut out what I could throughout this review so you could see how this game plays. Based on the eShop's details, Milanoir released May 31st, 2018 for $12.99. The game's supported play modes are TV, tabletop, and handheld. And if the Pro Controller is your controller of choice, it supports that too. Let's check out some of the gameplay. Before we start playing in the game, let's take a look at the menu. Here's the start, and this is where we would start the chapters. But before we get into that, let's check out the other areas, like the arena. The arena is where two players can battle it out. Fortunately, I haven't had a chance to try this out yet, so I'll have to come back to that some other time. But at least we know it's there, and we can do some one or two player battles. Next is the options, and there's quite a few options here. Although I'm not going to change anything yet, because I need to see what it has to start with. It is good to see what they have a lot of things that you can change. For example, the difficulty. And as you can see, the hardcore flashing there. That means you could probably unlock that. The extras will show you character profiles. Since just started the game, it's only showing us one, and we have to unlock the others and come back to it and check it out when we've unlocked them. Now that we've got through the menu, let's get started with the game. And since I've started it already with just the prelude, we'll start there. Now, to let you know, Milanoir is a single player or co-op action shooter game. And it kind of reminds me of the first two GTA games mixed with the current GTA type stories, being deep into the gangster underworld and relentless violence. However, Milanoir is set in the 70s, and I don't believe any of the GTA games were. And it is made to feel like you are watching a classic gangster movie as well in that era. I believe in the description it also mentioned that they were Quentin Tarantino fans, or it was meant to mimic those movies that Quentin Tarantino likes. So here is where our story picks up. Now keep in mind that I did edit this gameplay. Again, I'm trying to cut out some things so that you could review this game or watch this video without worrying about anything inappropriate coming up. I tried my best, so there should not be anything that comes up that would get you in trouble. Or at least make you have to explain things to your children if you're a dad and or a mom. So, but anyways, this gameplay does cut in and out. I edited it for content and for this to show the gameplay at least. But basically, I jumped some scenes just to show that we had to go and get go after this lady who sent out the guy who tried to kill us in the bathroom. So, or at least get some more clues as to why they were trying to kill me. So I'm in the brothel, and I had to heavily edit this area, so because it does show some scenes, you don't, enough things are shown. So just be aware of that if you do want to buy this game. But that's one of the good things about having a Switch, is being able to get a game like this, especially if you have kids, and be able to play it in privacy in handheld mode. And then if you can, you can always bring it to TV later. But here in this area, I wanted to make sure to show some of the content that was available. So that you can see how the gameplay available and how some of the action sequences take place. So like what you saw before was the B button to silently attack someone, and the ZL and directional button to jump over things. Here I'm trying to get an idea of the controls and also trying to see if I can actually go in any doorways. So yes, I'm not crazy, I'm not trying to go, I'm not losing my mind here. I'm just trying to see if I can actually do certain things with the other buttons here. So at this point, this is where the lady I was looking for jumped out of the tub, and I had to react quickly. So I had to kill the lady in the bathtub, who she was with, and she ran off. The other lady I was after, she ran off in that way. So going after her. Again, I'm splicing out some of the things that I didn't want to show here in the YouTube video. Now I'm trying to find the lady I was after. And here's again some of the action sequences or action gameplay sequences that you can do. You can hide behind things, duck behind things when going after people or shooting people. Of course, when somebody comes at me with a knife, it's for some reason I'm having a hard time trying to kill the lady because she just comes right at you. But this again helps you get a feel for the game and getting behind items to protect yourself and to do a little gunplay. And in this section, I believe this is where... Nope, not yet. But in the next section, when you get towards the end, is where a bunch of people come at you and then you run out of bullets. This is where I run out of bullets and have no idea why until this extra character comes out to push the story forward. Basically, we're both looking for Africana and I need to chase her down in the courtyard and she'll come again later to help me out more. I have to say the next gameplay element that comes up right here, ricochet kills element, is pretty cool. I had a lot of fun with this when we're playing this game, and later on in the game you actually hit the triangular signs and the bullet will actually split off and kill two people. It's a very different and unique gameplay element that I haven't experienced before. Maybe somebody could tell me in the comments if they've experienced something similar in another game. Here in this scene, I had to come up with, had to figure out a way to kill Africana, and that was to use the signs for ricocheting. Should have known better, learned a new thing, and you had to use the new thing to kill the boss. So, took some time to go back and forth between the two signs and ricochet the bullet off so that I could get some damage done to her. Fast forward it, this is where I am, and get her killed. She says a few choice words. Takes off, and now we get into a car chase, which is pretty cool. So that lady comes to help me out, that helped me out before. She's in the back of the vehicle. She's the one that's going to be shooting, and I'm the one driving. However, something that I found out the hard way is I'm driving and also controlling the lady and where she's shooting. So it did take me a few tries to get through this section just so I could get my aim down and to avoid the van. So because when the van kept ramming into me, it would do damage to me like that, along with those other guys trying to shoot me, and I would die. So here is where just basically a couple trials and trial and errors, and I got through it and moved on to the next phase of the race, or the car chase scene, which is Africana popping out the back and starting to shoot at me, like here. So again, this took some getting used to, being able to steer out of the way of her shooting, at the same time me trying to aim at her and shoot back. Eventually I did succeed, got through it, as you can see, and moved on. Essentially, this ends chapter one, and we can then move on to chapter two. But basically, I wanted to get through this chapter and share it with you guys and show you what the gameplay was like so that you could make a decision on whether you would like to get this game for yourself. I actually started playing it more after recording this first part of the game, and before I edited this video, and having a lot of fun with it. It is hard at times. I can only imagine what the hardcore mode is like, or even the difficult mode is like. But I am having a lot of fun with it. Of course, keeping it away from my 10-year-old son, because he wanted to play. But I'm looking forward to maybe having my wife try it out with me in the co-op mode. Or when my friends and I have a game night, maybe I'll have one of them help me out. But that's essentially the review today, and I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you guys can make a decision from it. And with that, until next time, this is Tim signing off. Check you later.